It is time to vote if you're in Georgia. The early voting in the two Senate runoffs has begun. And this is important. More than half of the record 5 million votes in the November 3rd general election were cast during its 2-week early voting period there in Georgia. Early and posting voting could be even more important because of the short time frame that voters have to request and send back ballots by mail. The period isn't as long. And it could also be important because there's going to be far fewer actual voting sites in most counties to go and vote in. But this is your heads up. If you're in Georgia, the future of the Senate is now in your hands. Hopefully you have already voted.
Yeah, we have the get your booty to the poll. My favorite get out the vote campaign. And with a bunch of erotic dancers, exotic. I don't know whether it's erotic or exotic. I never know. Many of them are exotic strippers. And I love that. So yes, early voting has begun. Yeah. And get your booty to the poll, do a little dance while you do it. Also, there's going to be, I mean, I know we're gonna talk about this, but there's the shenanigans only roll on. But I hope that some of the ridiculousness that the GOP has perpetuated around the reliability of this election will suppress some of the Republican voters who are like, nah, Loeffler and Perdue don't love my president. We will see. It's going to be tough though.
Yeah. Look, I want everyone in America to vote, preferably based on an accurate idea of the facts, the stakes, and all of that. We're never going to have that, of course, but I want it to be as easy as possible to vote in America. Not everyone actually agrees with that. And so look, it's not gonna surprise most of you that the Republicans are against democracy. But when I make that case, I'm sure some mouth breathing Republicans would say that no, that's not true. So when possible, I like to add a little bit more evidence to the pile. Here is Newt Gingrich saying, why is Georgia Secretary of State Raffensperger working so hard to add drop boxes and take other steps to make it harder for Republicans to win? Is he really that intimidated by Stacey Abrams? I wanna be fair. I don't know what other interpretation of that tweet there is then. If more people vote, Republicans will lose. Is there another way to take that tweet from the former Speaker of the House for the Republicans?
I interpret it as I am afraid of Stacey Abrams. That's really what he's saying. He says, we've seen the movement she's mobilized and the incredible voter turnouts in November. And the massive registration that her organization has you know, piloted. And yeah, I'm scared. So you need to remove like ballot boxes, which we've discussed for so long, also hurts Republicans. Republicans might not have an idea of, you know, who to vote for when it comes to their best interests, but they, some of them just wanna drop off their ballot as well.
Yeah, totally. Yeah, and I'm trying to, AJ Nestor on Twitch said, he said that out loud. Yeah, they just, because again, like their voters understand, like their voters back in the day maybe would have liked the sort of the idea, the narrative that the Republicans are in favor of democracy. They're the defenders of democracy and all of that. They still would have wanted the suppression, especially of black and brown voters, but they would have liked that. But now they get that. That is not the way the country is working, either demographically or in terms of politics, in terms of how the parties can respond to the crises that are actually facing us. They know that if people are able to freely and easily register and vote, the Republicans won't win. And so one of two things is gonna happen. Either the Democrats are always going to win, or the Republicans are gonna have to actually change their policies. And with those as the two options, most Democratic voters are fine with suppression to stop either of those things from happening. And they don't mind the fact that it's totally open. That one of the highest profile Republicans in the country can just say, more voting is bad for Republicans, and it's barely even news.
Yeah.
But anyway, I also saw a comment saying John registered to vote. Well, I don't live in Georgia. My brother does, but I don't live in Georgia. But you all should register to vote. So in addition to telling you to do that now, I also want to use this as an opportunity to let you know about the special event that's going to be airing later on today on the TYT network, the Georgia Get Out the Vote special, which is going to be hosted by myself and Benjamin Dixon. Along the way, we're going to be joined by Mondale Robinson, Justin Horowitz, Rashad Ritchie, Ida Rodriguez, Cenk Uygur's going to be there. Man, that's an awesome crew of people that are going to be there. And you can watch that at 5:30 p.m. Pacific time, 8:30 p.m. Eastern time at tyt.com/live. And I'm sure also on our YouTube and our Twitch and everything like that. We're going to give you information about how to get involved, whether you live in Georgia or not, you can help this effort. We're going to give you information about the stakes, about the people who are running and all of that. So hopefully people will be like all aboard, because this is really important. It couldn't get more important right now.
Yeah, absolutely. And the last thing I'll say is, you know, I think Gingrich also said the other day that, you know, he repeated this line that America is not a democracy, we're a republic, which is like saying a poodle is not a dog, it's a canine. It's the same thing. Like, republic just means you're not a monarchy. You know, it's and democracy then means by the people, and it's virtually the same thing. But I was talking with Astra Taylor, who's this awesome, you know, organizer and writer. And she has documented the way that the Republicans have leaned into the idea of minority rule. And the way that they, instead of in 2012, when they were told after Romney lost that they really need to expand their voting base with Latinos and African-Americans, they were like, yeah, cool, nuh-uh. And they were, you know, doubled and tripled down on essentially what is white supremacy embedded in the political system. And I think it's so fascinating because, you know, as a lot of, you know, as she and others point out, is that in the, you know, in the 80s, even Reagan was like, yay, democracy. And we're so used to democracy being sort of parroted and held up by people who ultimately don't believe in it, you know, and suppress the vote and like don't want people of color to vote. But now they're not even saying democracy. They're just saying that it is actually bad. Democracy is bad. And the founding fathers, quote, never wanted democracy in the first place. And in fact, there's some grounds for that, but there, of course, but there's also, it seems like they did evolve on the question. But it is, let us never forget that, like, they're pivoting. They're pivoting because they can't win without regular suppression and regular cheating. So now the pivot is, it's a messaging pivot. It's just, we should be suppressing and cheating because this country was always meant for landowning white men to have more of a say than everybody else. That's it.
Yeah. It's something more fundamental than democracy that they can claim to represent. It's like that, it's a hidden extra level. Like how, you know, Trump ran as he's gonna be an outsider, he's gonna clean out government. But then once he's in government, they have to clean out the deep state. There's another layer of it that I have to get. I'm still an outsider, even though we have all the political power of the country. Still an outsider.
Check out the Damage Report podcast each day, wherever you get your podcasts, whether Pocket Casts or Stitcher or iTunes. You can join me as I give you the news and stories you want, with a range of co-hosts and interview guests jumping in on the fun each day. Again, that's the Damage Report, wherever you get your podcasts. And if you get them at iTunes, don't forget to rate and review. Sometimes I'll read them live on the show.